It's brought to you by allaboutmqm.org, the MQM's knowledge base.
Welcome back. You're watching Dawn News Live with Simon Morton. Well, let's take a look now at that Senate Standing Committee on Sports. Allegations about match fixing, and more specifically, how players might have underperformed deliberately during that tour to Australia. Well, I'm joined tonight by Senator Tahir Mashhadi from the Senate Committee on Sports. Good evening to you. Thanks very much indeed for being with us tonight. Perhaps you can share with us exactly what kind of evidence you have that players deliberately underperformed.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you for having me. Yesterday we had this meeting on sports, the performance of the Australian team, the dismal performance of the Australian team in of the cricket team during the Australian tour. And while the briefing was going on, I must commend the hard work put in by the Pakistan Cricket Board. They have done extremely well. They have carried out a thorough investigation, which they have recorded on video. And on paper, the statements were there, which they have given to us also, and they showed it to us, and we discussed it yesterday. Now, going through those video recording of the statements and the questioning and the question-answer sessions and the proof and the way the matches were played and the matches were lost, it became quite apparent that the three things were absolutely apparent. One is either there was match fixing of the highest order, or the players underperformed, or there was grouping in the team, so the team didn't get on as a national team, so they were all trying to let each other down, finally they played as individuals and not as a team, and the interest of Pakistan, because they were representing Pakistan.
Let's talk about this video that you say that you've been shown. What exactly was in that video? What did you see?
In the video, they showed us the complete inquiry, the way they conducted the inquiry. They've done it in a very transparent manner and a very thorough manner. There was the question and answers by the PCB board. They asked the management, which was there in Australia with them. They asked the players. They asked the captain. They asked all the concerned people there. And then, you had to link it with certain incidents on the cricket field. You are winning a match,
exactly,
and suddenly he runs and you've
got... Senator Mashhadi, what exactly...
...maiden over.
What exactly in that video, Senator Mashhadi, shows you?
And the ball is in somebody's hand and it just remains there, and the opponent batsman is stranded in the middle and he still doesn't get him out. So once you link it, you see, a match fixing is such a technical thing that you're never going to get a smoking gun, or you're never going to catch them actually taking the money. You have to go. So this is what we, in the interest of cricket, we want clean cricket, good cricket, and we wanted cricket on merit. We have a fantastic crop of young players waiting on the sidelines. We want them to be given a chance on merit, and if any of these senior players think they are indispensable, they should remember that the graveyards of the world are full of indispensable people. We must have zero tolerance as far as anything of these four things: underperformance, grouping, or letting your team down, or letting Pakistan down is absolutely unacceptable to the people of Pakistan.
Okay, Senator Mashhadi, I'm hoping you can hear me. I was asking you specifically what exact evidence do you have of perhaps match fixing? You mentioned some footage that was shown to you of catching balls and holding on to balls or not catching balls deliberately. Is that perhaps Garman Ekmal you were referring to?
No, I'm talking about generally. I'm not specifically mentioning anyone.
But you've seen a video. I'm asking you what was in the video.
More into the further details. We want a complete and thorough, because PCB is the responsible organization. They are handling the matter in a very responsible manner. They have started punishing players for various omissions and commissions committed, but these piecemeal type of punishments, if because they must prove it beyond a shadow of doubt. We don't want to witch hunt anybody. We don't want career of players destroyed or anything just because of whim or likes or dislikes or favoritism. We want justice for the people of Pakistan.
Okay, but there's still some confusion because the Senate Sports Committee, which holds the PCB and its sportsmen accountable, has said that it has seen evidence of match-fixing or underperforming. I want to know exactly what that is. You've still not told us exactly what that is.
No, actually, that's what I'm trying to explain, that there will be no smoking gun. There will be no proof, solid proof, which I can give to you, Saima. This is something that is Crony case and Azharuddin case, and these cases are before us. Then the Qayyum Commission of Pakistan is before us, where certain Pakistani players were banned for life. Then there are other players who were banned for little while periods, and they have been let off. Now, this is why, because you can't get that absolute proof. We just cannot take the risk. As far as the Senate Committee, as the oversight body is concerned, we saw that there was something drastically wrong on the Pakistan tour of Australia. There is no doubt whatsoever about that. Now, once those things were wrong, underperformance, definitely it was there. Letting down each other, that is definitely down there. Now, if you take match fixing in the broader context, even if you don't play as a team, or you try to run out somebody, or you miss a catch, or this, that, the other, intentionally to harm the result of the game, that will also, in the broader sense of it, go. But we don't want tolerance of that. We will not tolerate that because we are capable of producing the world's best cricketers. We produced the Hanif Brotheran, we produced Zaheer Abbas, we produced Imran Khan, we produced Waqar Yunus, we have the Mushtaq Mohammed. You see, the list doesn't end. We have fantastic.
Let's just talk about your committee and how much it is very confident, because it sounds a little flimsy. On the one hand, you've come out and you and the rest of the committee have come out and specifically said that we have evidence or we are investigating match fixing, but then on the other hand, you're not willing to name players or specific incidents. But this sounds very flimsy. It's almost like the Senate committee cannot really commit itself either way and is making very mixed and very serious allegations.
Actually, this is the very reason why we want more thorough investigation. This is the very reason why we want the Pakistan Cricket Board to come out and tell the people of Pakistan specifically and for once and for all. We have no desire whatsoever to witch hunt. We want them to come out with the facts. They came out, they said that we are going to ban certain players for life. They later on changed it they are banned for indefinite. Nobody gets banned for bad performance. Nobody gets banned for bad behavior. The banning for life is very, very clear why it's done. Now, if the Pakistan Cricket Board has also been instructed or requested or indicated by the ICC, we want that to come out and that to be told to the nation. Now, if they have not, then what we have seen and what we have heard in that committee definitely indicates that all is not well in the Pakistan cricket.
Okay, and therefore, you can enlighten us then.
Doubt, that shadow of doubt to be removed, and so that the people of Pakistan can really get to know. You see, we are a very emotional nation. We love our cricket and we love our cricketers. We treat them as heroes and we want our heroes to remain as our heroes. But if they must give back to the nation what they have taken from the nation makes them, they must make the nation also. That is why we want a clear picture of this to come out and get it clarified.
Let's talk about these specific bans and fines, for example. You've presumably been reviewing that with the PCB and there's been this inquiry. Why then was Yunus Khan and Mohammed Yusuf recommended not for selection, and then Shoaib Malik and Rana Naveed given?
Now, first of all, I personally clarified about Shahid Afridi. I asked this question in the meeting. Personally, I asked about this. I said, Shahid Afridi, I want to know, did he do anything wrong on this tour other than that ball tampering? Because for the ball tampering, he has been punished.